Hey there, ladies. Nat Carter, personal trainer and fitness expert from NatalieCarterTalksFitness.com. Today we are talking about cellulite. And FYI, everybody has it. We just have it in different amounts compared to other people out there. So let's dive straight into it and talk about the fact that it's not gonna go away, no matter how much sucking or creaming or anything that you do. It's a natural thing that all women have that we actually need in the structure of our skin. So I wanted to get that out there straight away. I have it, models have it, hairdressers have it, mums have it, old ladies have it, young people have it, everybody freaking has it. So we just really need to get over the fact that we feel like we're the only one that has it. There's a couple of things in regards to the structure of the skin, and you might be, well, I know I thought about it. I thought, why don't men really have cellulite? Like, unless they're a bit flabby. But men don't really have cellulite because they have a different structure with their skin. Their skin's a bit oilier, and it's it has a different structure to it. So that's why women are a little bit more prone to it. Our hormones are different as well too. So just a few key things I want to get out there. I guess, like, as I said, we have all got it. It all comes in, you know, some of us have buckets of it and others don't really. Now, speaking from a personal experience, I don't really have lots of cellulite. However, I have weight trained from a very young age, like into my teens up until now. So it's over 15 years that I've weight trained, and I just haven't really got loads of bumpy, dimply kind of cellulite. Don't get me wrong, I definitely have it. I have fat deposits all throughout my body. But understand too, as that natural predisposition to it, you're going to have it on the backs of your arms, you're going to have it on the backs of your legs, your inner thighs. It's a natural thing, it's there for a reason. And if we are trying so super hard to take it away, then, you know, there can be health implications down the road, which is what you don't want. But I am all about solutions, and I do want to give you a few tips on how you can help minimize it. So we don't want to diminish it. I know everyone does, but, like, let's be realistic here. We can't totally erase it. So definitely diet is key here. So you want to be making sure that you're eating, obviously, lots of fresh fruit and vegetables, whole grains, getting a really nice wide variety and a balanced diet. You want to try to minimize your the amount of sugar that you have in your diet, because sugar causes inflammation. And so when we're all puffy and etc., we know how that makes us feel and we know how it makes us look. So decreasing our sugar intake is a key one as well. And making sure you're getting your carb sources from whole grains, whole foods, I should say. You don't have to eat grains if you don't particularly feel that your body thrives that way. So number one, diet. Also encompassing in diet is your water intake. It's always a great idea for skin to make sure that you do drink a sufficient amount of water. And nice, clean, filtered water as well too. It's like a no-brainer. Don't be like my cat and drink out of the dirty puddles. Now, exercise choice. So when it comes to exercises that you can do for your, let's focus on, like, the thighs and the bum. That's where most women tend to get quite a lot of, that's like their bulk of where their cellulite is. Obviously, making sure that you're weight training. So doing your squats, doing your lunges, doing your step ups, having that resistance component is going to help you. Like I said, initially, I've been weight training for a very long time, over 15 years. I would 100% say that I would have had way more cellulite if it wasn't for the weight training. So the fact that we're trying to build our muscle, we're trying to kind of change the structure of our fat levels and our muscle levels. So, you know, the more, it's not that fat weighs more than muscle, it's the same. But obviously the space that it takes up. So if we can reduce the body fat around the muscles, that's always a good thing. So yes, definitely weight training, getting out there and doing your high intensity interval training as well. Sprinting is great. But you know, like everything, you've got to kind of do your exercising in moderation with your diet. Your diet is going to be the thing that that really helps drop your body fat levels. So we've discussed diet. We've discussed water, hydration. We've discussed the exercise component. So I definitely think that you should be doing that. Creams, stay the hell away from any cellulite fixer, magical eraser that's going to erase stretch marks, erase fine lines. All of that kind of crap is just a real ploy to get women to spend a lot of money. We're talking millions and millions of dollars in the beauty industry is, you know, siphoned out of our wallets and tapped right into our insecurities about our body. And it sucks, but it's always going to happen because everyone wants to make money. But really what I recommend, things that actually do work and don't require you to spend a lot of money, are things like, you know, trying to get into the realm of organic beauty. Even using things like body scrubs in terms of like just really simple coconut oil, a little bit of raw sugar, and just kind of, you know, working it over the areas there. You're not going to get in super deep, but it's just going to help with the appearance of the skin texture. Body brushing is another great one too. I really love using organic beauty products as well. If you don't know now, I've kind of I'm working my way to make the total switch through everything. I love Walita's products. They've got a really great range of different products. But you know, when you're putting oils onto the skin too, it's going to improve the skin texture. So personally for me, I don't tend to use a lot of harsh scratchy kind of fake plasticky micro bead products. I don't use those. It's just tends to be a lot of oils, a lot of natural products. Getting in there, even just getting in with a really good flannel and really kind of going over the areas like around your legs, ass, etc., is great. But really, once you understand that no amount of cream is going to change how much cellulite you have, it's like fucking liberating. So yes, look, oils are great because I think, you know, that they soak really well into the skin, and that is my that's my suggestion in terms of like products to use. Now we also need to start to realize that, like I said initially, every woman has cellulite. So get talking to your friends, get talking to other women that you feel comfortable with, and ask them if they have cellulite, where they have cellulite. And it really just helps you to understand that you're not this freak. Like, no one is prone to cellulite or anything like that. So we all have it. It's all made up. We all have body fat because we need it. So that kind of, you know, a problem shared is a problem aired. We get to experience what other women are going through. It's not just us, you know, and we're not the only one that's got cellulite. Another important key is stop reading fucking magazines. Stop looking at magazines at celebrities. Like one time they're kind of like, oh my god, this person's so amazing, look how beautiful is, she's so natural, she's so young, she's so vibrant, just look at her amazing clothes. The next minute they're slagging her off because she's got a saggy fat ass and she's got cellulite because she's in a bikini. It's just, you know, that constant media attention on the body all the time, it's not good for your psyche. So if you can ditch the mags, I know some people love them and they're addicted to them, but if you can ditch the mags and ditch all that kind of beauty bullshit, it just really lightens up your life. You don't really have to, I know it's nice to sometimes when you're getting a haircut flick through magazines, but it's just like a lot of crap. So if we try to kind of boost our self-confidence and understand that We're all in the same boat together. Some of us have a little, some of us have a lot. We're all different body types and body structures. I'm so glad that it hasn't taken me too long in my life to realize that I'm a different body shape to a supermodel or to, you know, other clients of mine or friends, etc. And it's really about embracing it. I know that seems relatively easy enough, but it does take a lot of time sometimes to just be at peace with our bodies. So yeah, look, let's really focus on those things that work. Don't need to go under the surgeon's knife because it's all just gonna come back. Think about the diet, think about the workout choices. So making sure you add resistance training in there. You're doing really great with your hydration levels. You're trying to get in there with some nice products on your skin, aiming for organic, natural, trying to stay away from all the kind of, you know, toxic, processed, tested on animal products, because they disrupt your hormone levels as well too. That's a really important thing. So if you stop using all the crappy, and there's so many, I know I'm jumping all over the place, but there's so many great organic products. If you don't know by now too, I love Nourish Life, their website. They have so many good, non-toxic beauty options. It's so easy. You literally just click and there's so much to choose from. So yeah, we really don't have to go down this natural route and think, oh gosh, it's going to be, you know, like weird smelling stuff on my skin and it's not going to work. And you just got to try it. That's my biggest point. Okay, so yes, cellulite, we've all got it. Embrace it. But yes, understand that it's going to be there and it's going to help you. You're going to be nice and healthy with just a little bit of jiggle. So let's jiggle. Today's mine. Have a super day, ladies, and we will see you real soon. Goodbye.